Hello and welcome to the Garage Series from New Orleans. My name is Jeremy Chapman.
And I'm Keith Laborde.
So we are here this week at New Orleans, really going through all of the office products and the entire stack. One of the things that we've really changed how we think about is how we onboard customers with Office 365.
That's right. What we've done is looked at some of the complexities and times and difficulties it's taken to move to the service, and now we've really cut that back and made it much simpler.
So it's really about a simple three-step approach to get quick time to value so you can be up and running very, very quickly.
That's exactly right. Three simple steps: pilot, deploy, and enhance.
Right. So before we get started and talking about all these great things, we're going to kick off with today's trivia question.
True or false? When using the new ID fix tool to remediate Active Directory attributes before running dir/sync, you cannot undo changes made by the tool.
So stay tuned to the end of the show for the answer to today's trivia. So when we think about Office 365 and how we onboard, it really has gone to this three-step approach where we can basically, in an additive way, add more and more integration as we go.
Exactly.
So when we think about that, basically what we can do initially is we might have our cloud, and that's just going to give us the core Office 365 services. That's something that you might want to do, just manually provision users, maybe list import any of that stuff. And that really is about just piloting.
So that's essentially what we're looking to do is pilot in hours. So you can bring users on with cloud IDs. They can experience the full elements of the service without having to spend a lot of time getting there.
So it's really about getting that done in hours. Now, in terms of the next step, what you can do, and this is, again, all very additive, we can then do things like layer on our AD. So we might want to do directory synchronization at that point to really populate the users into the ID store.
That's right.
That's not something we have to do right in the pilot. That's something we can do later. And then at that point, we might want to be using Exchange and have all of those services running for email and those types of things. We might have some hybrid, or we might have that just running standalone at this point. But important thing is we can layer those things on later.
Yeah, exactly. A key point there is what we want to do is be able to go from pilot to production without having to throw anything away. So everything that you've done in pilot persists into the deploy phase.
Right, and this is more in terms of days, right?
That's correct, yep.
So after this phase, there we go. After this phase of getting the directory and the exchange in place, then we've really got our enhance phase where we can basically, if we want to even go further in terms of integration, that's where we might want to do things like Active Directory federation services. Right, so then we can have all of our password policies be coming from our internal identity provider, all that stuff, password management, et cetera, is being done in-house. Then we might want to have, you know, integration between our SharePoint or start migrating some SharePoint data, so we might have some of that. And then in terms of other things that we can do, link, getting more services and getting some more richness in terms of some of the link pieces that are in place. And that really is the enhanced phase where we can basically layer in more and more integration. Instead of doing all of this work up front, we can basically add that to the end of the deployment. And that thing, that's more about weeks as opposed to hours or days. So this is where you're actually spending a little bit more time and getting more integrated.
That's exactly right. And what you can see is we've really reordered the steps where traditionally we had done all of the enhanced work up front. Now we're moving that towards the back, but still allowing the user to get the feel of the complete service throughout.
Right, and with FastTrack, we've also done a lot of work in terms of the onboarding experience and what you see as a consumer of all of this when you log in. So why don't you show us a couple of demonstrations, Keith, about all the different things that we've built to make this whole process a lot more intuitive.
Yeah, absolutely. Let me run through a couple of demos here. What we'd like to show you first is the FastTrack site that we've talked about. So as you can see what I've got here, I've got fasttrack.office.com up, and this is really breaking it down into the three easy steps that we have in place. So we've got a video there that will walk you through all of the steps that you need to go through. But really the first thing you're looking to do is really start with the pilot. And when you go to the pilot, it will show you all of the steps that that you're really looking to do and move forward with, from getting started, setting up your users, using cloud IDs, and so forth. Once they move through the pilot, they can then go to step two, which is the deploy phase, and that will really walk you through from what you've done in the pilot, but now you can start to really set up your pilot domain, you can add users, you can connect your existing email accounts. So you, at that point, you really start to experience the core features of the service.
And you can kind of see with the side, it's, you know, it's a very fresh design, very, very inviting in terms of how it's laid out. It's a lot different than if you're used to, say, TechNet libraries and all those things. We tried to make it really welcoming and really an easy experience.
Exactly. Yeah, the whole thought here is just to keep things as simple and easy as possible, and that's really what we've done here in designing FastTrack.
Right, so when we get to the next phase in terms of onboarding, then we go into something called OnRamp, right?
That's right. OnRamp is a tool that will help you configure the service and walk through really what the steps are that are required to get there. And kind of keeping in mind with what we've put in place, we've really designed kind of an OnRamp tool for Office 365 that helps you really deploy on your terms.
Right, so that then will kind of walk you through what you're trying to get done and all of that stuff, right?
Exactly. So as you can see here, what we've done is we've got our deploy tenant set up. We're selecting Office 365. What we want to do is pick all of the services, so Exchange, SharePoint, Link, and Office. This will really align kind of the features with what we've got in place for the service. We'll be able to pick that we want to synchronize with our on-prem AD for Office 365. From this point, it's going to ask us about migration. It's really, you know, kind of allowing us to configure this the way that we want to use this and really walking us through each step. It will also walk through kind of the readiness features. So it'll go in and check our environment to make sure that our current environment is already ready for the cloud and prepared for that. So we'll do some automated checks here, and I'll just click on the readiness steps. And then as you can see, it looks for preparation of DIR sync, Active Directory synchronization. We'll verify the directory sync. We'll then activate users, and we'll work through all of the auto checks at this point. So I'm going to run through a few checks right here. You'll start to see that we're checking for credentials. We're checking for our network. Domains, users. First, I have to be a domain-joined machine. So that's really the only credentials that I need to put in there. But then we'll start to work through all of those. And as you can see, each of those checks are beginning to work and each
request. Once all the green lights are on, then you can just start deploying and having all those services.
That's exactly right. At that point, your environment is ready and everything is set up to begin moving to the cloud.
Awesome. So something else I think that's new that we wanted to show kind of one of the first looks at was something called ID Fix.
So yeah, exactly. Yeah, so with ID Fix, what you want to do is we'll go in and we'll select the executable. It'll run through a couple of statements here. And essentially what ID Fix is going to do, you know, we used to hear that it took so much time for AD remediation. So what we tried to do is really simplify identifying the errors within DIR sync, but not only calling those out, but also being able to fix them. And so what you've seen here is we've put everything into a simple interface that really allows you to understand what needs to happen to get your Active Directory preparation in order. So here we're running through a couple of checks. We're looking at a blank display name. We know that that's going to end up erroring out for user 7, so we click Edit. We move down through a couple of the other errors here and working through some of the duplicate entries, also wanting to remove that one. And then what we're going to do here is pull another one on the same account name and edit those as well.
Great. So we can do multi-select of all the different objects, things that we want to actually fix the attributes of. That will then, ID Fix will then remediate some of those, those items, right?
Yep, we can apply those fixes. It'll come back, it'll tell us that we're complete. We then re-query, and as you can see, the information here has been corrected, and ID Fix work has been cleaned up, and the directory is now clear.
So I know one of the scary things when you're doing directory cleanup is, how do I undo any changes?
Right.
What if I break somebody when I, you know, maybe get the punctuation, the period off of a junior, or all those types of things, or blank attributes that maybe needed to be there for one reason or another.
Exactly, and so that's one of the key items that we built into ID Fix, is that you do have the ability to go back and undo something. So the tool will automatically pull that forward. So if you go in and you pick undo, as you can see what we're demoing here now, for the users, we're able to go back in, undo it, and then as we apply those settings, you'll see that the action is complete and you're back to the original state.
Right, very cool. And then it obviously logs everything that it's doing. You can get a very in-depth text file of everything that's gone on with all of that tool and its workings. So you have all of the instrumentation there.
Yes.
So we thought, Keith, that we would test, you know, from a deployment perspective, what the speeds looked like, because Garage is all about, you know, fast installs, jumping out of airplanes, all that stuff.
Yep.
How fast it would be to install Exchange Server versus get an Office 365 full E3 tenant up and running with SharePoint, Exchange, Link, the whole thing. So we decided to do a challenge in New Orleans. Let's see how that went. So here we are in New Orleans. We wanted to really put Exchange on-premises versus online to the test. So I'm going to be doing an Exchange online installation with 100 users using Office 365.
And I'm going to set up a test environment with Exchange Server 2013 using Hyper-V on my mobile workstation.
Well, that's a big unit you've got there.
That's how I roll.
While you work with that big, huge piece of luggage, I'm going to do all of that tethered to my Surface RT device from my phone. So, want to meet back here in 30 minutes?
Let's see how we go.
Sounds good.
So I found the perfect place to install Exchange Server. It's a dark, windowless room, comfy chair, and my secret weapon, it's an Ethernet connection. So, let's get started.
So while Alistair's pinned to his dingy office with that big piece of machinery, I've got my Surface RT tethered to my Windows phone, and I can work from anywhere.
Setup needs to copy files are required to install Exchange Server.
And I'm free to roam about the city.
Geez, I love having SSDs on my workstation. So I'm configuring Windows features. It'll require a restart. It might slow me down a little bit, but if I want to slow down Jeremy as well, I might just email him some really big attachments to try and knock out his phone. Now Jeremy's out on the road, so he's probably using tethering on his phone, so I might just give him a quick call to slow him down a bit.
Hey, Alistair, how are you doing?
Great, great. Yeah, I just thought we'd have a chat about all that tethering solution you're working with. How's that working out?
Hey, you're trying to suck all my bandwidth? Yeah, I'm really worried about that.
Step 3 of 15, copying Exchange files. I think this setup is going pretty well. There's nothing quite like watching a progress bar.
Hey Alistair, how's it going? Yeah, well I just imported all of my users into my tenant and everything's ready to go on my end, so I guess I'll see you in 10 minutes. Wow, that was pretty funny. So really, not really a fair race. It was pretty lopsided, wasn't it?
Yeah, exactly. It looks like we were able to deploy to the cloud in half the time.
So it was really about 45 minutes in our case to get an Exchange Server up and running, and about 20 minutes or so to get not only Exchange, but we also got SharePoint running and Link at the same time. So all those services were firing, everything was working.
Yeah, exactly. What we did, we flipped the approach and the methodology, and we moved all the simple steps up to the very beginning and left the complexities and enhancements towards the end.
Right, so and according, like we talked about in our three-step process, they can layer in more and more integration as they go. So even though I did one list import of 100 users, if I want to, I can set up 80 federation later, I can do all the things around hybrid exchange, all that other stuff, and I can layer that in.
Exactly.
As I deploy Office 365 even further into the organization.
Yeah, we were able to get the full use of the service, looking at Exchange, SharePoint, and Link throughout, and never missing any of the user experience.
So we had a trivia question earlier. Let's take a look at the answer.
True or false? When using the new ID fix tool to remediate Active Directory attributes before running dirsync, you cannot undo changes made by the tool.
Great stuff. So this information and more is available on our blog at Microsoft.com /garage, and of course, on all the Office 365, the FastTrack site?
Yes, it's fasttrack.office.com.
So those are all the resources that you're going to need to get Office deployed and up and running very, very quickly. So thanks, everybody, for watching, and goodbye for now.